Hey folks, welcome back to Math Teacher Lounge. I'm Dan Meyer.
And I'm Bethany Lockhart Johnson.
And we are heading into the holiday season in the thick of it. And so for this episode, we figured that we would bring for each other a little potluck, a few of our favorite side dishes, maybe a main dish, and just bring those to share with each other and with you folks and see what you think about them.
Say a little more about that, Dan. A potluck, a math potluck? Am I bringing my grandma's famous sweet potato and marshmallow dish, which don't knock it till you tried it?
Well, how'd I knock that? It sounds great. I wish that I had requested that. But instead, we're going to bring a few artifacts that we've seen from around the internet, some interesting proceedings from conferences. The internet offers us a bounty of exciting mathematical ideas and from around the internet. And so we'll bring those to you folks and share them with you.
A veritable feast of math deliciousness.
So here's the first dish I brought, Bethany. This right here is a Desmos activity from the one, the only, Jay Chow. It asks for five pies you have strong feelings about or are at least familiar with. Give me some pies here.
Pumpkin. Sweet potato.
Name it.
Apple.
Go.
Lemon meringue.
Okay.
And then my mother's favorite, strawberry rhubarb.
Okay, great selections. What your boy Jay Chow asked you to do is to choose whether they're savory or sweet, first of all. So pumpkin, sweet, apple. Anyway, go through all these. Are any of these savory? What's savory here?
Well, like lemon meringue to me would be like all the way over in the sweet category. And sweet potato, while if you make it like I make it, it's towards, okay, I don't make sweet potato pie, but I sure do eat it. And it would be sweet, but not as sweet as lemon meringue.
Gotcha. You know? So he has you rank all these things right here. Perfect. He has you rank it like based on crust. Is it more pastry? Is it more filling? Is it available all the time? Like it's a real whole numbers cornucopia here. You can invite your students or your fellow teachers to participate in with an activity we'll have in the show notes. But the part that I loved about this, it goes for like, is it tasty? Is it not tasty? What's your overall rating? Anyway, it goes wild. This right here, this is several hundred math teachers on the internet, like selected their pies and did the work of ranking them, which allows us to see like, all right, let's check out the taste of any pie on here. Which pie do you think is gonna be most tasty for people? Bethany, what's your thinking here?
I think the least controversial would probably be apple, in my opinion.
I wonder if apple's like kind of mid-range tasty, but it's like clustered around the average tastiness. Not a lot of like, ooh, like a, I don't know if like strawberry rhubarb might have some really passionate defenders, but some low ratings. What's the all say? Here's the overall, overall very tasty here in this like middle range, but if we look at apple, pumpkin, pecan.
I want to see sweet potato because sweet potato is my favorite type of pie, but it can really divide people.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think we're seeing that there with that division. A lot of folks there at the along both edges. Some folks saying not tasty. Anyway, I just thought this was a really fun way to like think about graphs. One variable, two variable, all about pies. We'll have this in the show notes. Give it a look. Thanks for playing along, Bethany. And now I'm interested in what you have for us.
I kind of took the theme in a different direction. I am unfortunately not bringing anything food related, although now I'm very excited for some pie. I want to talk to you a little bit about something I'm noticing in conference spaces. Conference spaces have not always been a space where everyone sees their identity reflected and everyone sees themselves as they are experiencing mathematics reflected in the session offerings and in the conversations that are being highlighted. And so I want to highlight that I am noticing workshops and spaces that really invite us to look at math not as disconnected from ourselves, but as a part of our being, as a part of who we are and our whole self. What I want to share with you is this beautiful image from Sunil Singh, who is an Amplify advisor. I have spent many, many, many hours of my youth in the beauty shop with my mother, my grandmother, my aunties as they were getting their hair braided. And it is a time of community, of laughter, of gossip, of real talk, and of community, like just, it's art, right? And so the art of hair braiding is, it's beautiful. It's an art, it's a skill. And this image It's a computer graphic simulation of the braid of a cornrow hairstyle. I'm like, I saw this and I got chills. And I feel like if I had seen images where parts of my family, things that look like my family, look like things that I see in my everyday life, if I had seen that in the math space and I had been invited to engage with these images mathematically, it would have radically shifted the way that I think about math and who I get to be in the math classroom. So I want to shout out these amazing educators for taking the conference space and bringing their perspectives, their lenses, their culture, their identity, their visions into this space and helping to reshape what conference space could look like. So that is a gift. That is a gift that makes me really excited for where conferences are heading, math conferences, virtual yes. and in person.
Yes. Food for the soul right there, Bethany. Really, thank you for sharing those. I love that these are all available to folks who are not currently attending conferences, in person, or just like head to Twitter and type in the hashtag and see what's out there and get a taste of the side dishes and mains that people are sharing out there. For my last item here, I just like, again, want to reflect back to your comments about how math often seems to require that people, you know, separate themselves from various parts of their humanity, their culture, in order to be successful in math class. I think you brought a lot of excellent examples of that, of counteracting that phenomenon. And also, like math can involve the humanities, like not just humanity, but the humanities, like the arts, as well. And so I want to just offer to folks, to you, that Desmos, our graphing calculator, is an artistic creative tool, and we're currently holding the Desmos Art Contest. Once again, I'm going to share with you, Bethany, two images of the Australian Sydney Harbor, okay? One of which is a photograph, and one of which is a graph, a mathematical graph. A photograph, mathematical graph. And I'm super curious if you'll be able to tell which is which. I think this is going to blow your mind and just everybody else's mind. Go, huh? Which one is a graph? All right. Okay. So we're not quite at like photorealism yet. Okay. But that's pretty great. There's some kid named Luke made that right there.
Hi, Luke. That's awesome.
Shout out to Luke. All out of graphs. And there's just others that people produce. This is last year, last year's winners and finalists. That right there is a swan. It's nothing but graphs right there. Isn't that a thing? Isn't that amazing? You can feel the light reflecting off of that swan. All graphs.
Yes, you can. But can you back up a second?
Yeah.
Art contest, graphing. So using the Desmos tool, you're entering. Say more.
Yeah. So like, if we head to the Desmos graphing calculator, I'm going to, create, a circle or something like that. And this right here, this is my contribution to the Desmos Art Contest. A circle I made. Do you like it? It's mine. So I can just take that. I take this, I save it, and I take this, this is my contest entry. I can take this and go to desmos.com/art and head to the contest link and then submit that thing. Anyway, lots of room to participate at different levels and a great project for your students in the last month of the calendar year. So again, desmos.com/art, and that's a fun thing for you folks to do. And a side dish I wanted to bring and share with you, Bethany.
Thanks, Dan Meyer. We hope that no matter how you are spending the end of 2021, that you are doing it with people that you care about and in ways that nourish and feel fantastic. So we hope that you'll also stay connected with us. You can head over to Facebook, Math Teacher Lounge, where you can join our community and have conversations about some of the topics that we are excited about, topics you're excited about. You can also find us on Twitter at MTL Show. We will be back in January with even more episodes. And again, thank you so much for choosing to spend some time with us here in the Math Teacher Lounge. And we cannot wait to see what you serve up, some of your side dishes.